Wisconsin. Tonight, G4 makes this great state the epicenter of Halloween. As homegrown filmmaker Mark Borchardt, the star of the documentary American Movie, along with his faithful associate Mike Schank, host an exclusive live presentation of Night of the Living Dead from their front yard in Menomonee Falls, Wisconsin. In celebration of this cannibalistic classic, there'll be commentaries from director George Romero himself and the screening of the world's first ever live zombie movie. So find a safe place to hide and barricade your front doors, because Mark and Mike are about to be unleashed live, uncensored, unsupervised, and unmedicated as we present Night of the Living Dead, live from Wisconsin.
Excellent. Hello, America. And it's so ably put, we're Mark and Mike, man.
Yeah.
And we're hosting Night of the Living Dead live from Wisconsin. We're at our front yard here in Menomonee Falls. It's going to get near freezing, man, so I hope everyone's dressed well. So, Mike, man, why don't you say hello to America?
Yeah, hi, and thanks for inviting me out tonight, Mark. We're going to have a great time. Hopefully everyone's viewing. And we got Kenny Keene, Chris Borchardt cooking brats on the grill back here by the garage. We got my lovely wife, Kate, that we'll introduce to you, and she'll be spending the rest of the night with us.
Hi, guys.
And also accompanying me on some music stuff. And we got people bobbing for apples. We got a reenactment of Night of the Living Dead. We got a screaming contest. We got about pretty many zombies, wouldn't you say?
Mike, you're knocking my socks off with this explosive train of verbiage, but I like it, man. And listen, man, come out if you can, because we need some zombies, we need some trick-or-treaters. On your screen, there's a hardcore address, and yeah, absolutely, man. And I think Mike did hit a proverbial nail on the head when he explained we're doing the first ever live horror film, zombie film, man. So as Night of Living Dead goes on, at the apex of our presentation, we're going to have this. And Mike's been so kind as to offer himself to star in this, man.
Right, and we need everybody to turn on their TV sets.
Absolutely. So, again, live from Wisconsin, man, it's Night of Living Dead.
Our title was Night of the Flesh Eaters. And when Walter Reed picked the film up, there was a movie called The Flesh Eaters. So they said, we have to change it. So Night of the Living Dead was their title. And when they changed the title, they didn't have a copyright bug on it. They assumed that it would be at the end of the film, which is where it's supposed to be. And so, no copyright on the movie. And that's how easy it was to just lose it. None of us noticed, nobody knew, but that's the way it goes, the one that got away.
The day the time changes, the first day of summer.
What?
It's 8 o'clock and it's still light out.
Yeah, a lot of good that extra daylight's gonna do us. We still have a 3-hour drive back. We're not gonna be home until after midnight.
Well, if it really bugged you, Johnny, you wouldn't do it.
Think I wanna blow Sunday on a scene like this? Look, we're either gonna have to move Mother out here or move the grave into Pittsburgh.
Well, she can't make a trip like this.
I don't know that she can't. Is there still some of that candy left?
No.
Look at this thing. We still remember. I don't. You know, I don't even remember what the man looks like.
Johnny, it takes you 5 minutes.
Yeah, 5 minutes to put the wreath on the grave and 6 hours to drive back and forth. Mm-hmm. Mother wants to remember, so we trot 200 miles into the country and she stays at home.
Well, we're here, John, all right?
Ladies and gentlemen... Dude. We're coming back on the air after an interruption due to technical problems.
There was nothing wrong with the radio. Must have been the station.
Which row is it in?
gotten up earlier.
Oh, look, I already lost an hour's sleep on the time change.
I think you complain just to hear yourself talk. There it is.
I wonder what happened to the one from last year. Each year we spend good money on these things. We come out here and the one from last year's gone.
Well, the flowers die and the caretaker or somebody takes them away.
Yeah, a little spit and polish, you can clean this up. Sell it next year. Wonder how many times we bought the same one. Hey, come on, Barb. Church was this morning, huh? Hey, I mean praying's for church, huh? Come on.
I haven't seen you in church lately.
Well... not much sense in my going to church. Do you remember one time when we were small, we were out here? It was from right over there. I jumped out at you from behind the tree, and Grandpa got all excited, and he shook his fist at me, and he said, "Boy, you be damned to hell!" Remember that? Right over there. Well, you used to really be scared here.
Hey, you're still afraid.
Stop it, I mean it.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Stop it, you're ignorant.
They're coming for you, Barbara.
Stop it, you're acting like a child.
They're coming for you. Look, there comes one of them now. Here he comes now. I'm getting out of here.
Johnny.
Mike, man, yeah, Kate, my heart is filled with joy. Yeah, congratulations.
Yeah,
that was a cold day, fun? Man. That just looked beautiful, man.
Yeah.
We filmed that out at Valhalla Cemetery in Milwaukee, man. So listen, man, stay tuned for more great stuff from Night of the Living Dead on G4, man.
Stay tuned to see if Barbara decides to pick up this pushy hitchhiker. And later, Mike serenades the neighborhood when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues. We're back. Now, here are Mark and Mike live from Wisconsin.
Excellent, man. Well, welcome back, man.
And great, yeah.
This is certainly a surprise to end up over here, man. I guess Mike's gonna bob for apples, man. But we also got to cast the main zombie, and Mike got to stay with me on this for our film, man.
Okay.
And referring to this, we still need folks to come down and audition, man, as the lead zombie. So dress up very
well
in that. So, absolutely. Now listen, Mike, we're gonna do bobbing for apples here, and you got to be focused.
Okay, now,
and I know you are, man.
Right.
Absolutely.
Now, how deep am I putting my head in that water? Because you told me that I had 3 minutes to get into my costume and dry my hair. Are you down for the cause? Or
yeah, I think in 200 years we'll all be dust. It won't matter,
right,
man.
It won't matter. So I should just stick my head under there, and we'll just, okay.
I think we were just a humble narrator.
Yeah, I think so. I think in reality, I don't have a chance here.
Good.
Yeah!
So. Good Lord.
Attaboy.
Certainly unexpected.
Someone's gonna win.
Oh, hey man, let's get back to the movie, Night of Living Dead on D4.
Some of us wanted to make a feature film and thought that we could do it. We were audacious enough to think that we could do something ourselves and, you know, raise enough local money to just get it together and try to do a little movie. So we tried to raise money for a sort of a very artsy-fartsy thing called The Wine of the Fawn and never got anywhere with it. But in talking to people about putting money in, they said, well, if you did something commercial like a horror thing, kicked in $600 a piece, and we actually started to go to work. We rented the farmhouse, and we had cameras and lights and all that stuff in the company, so it was easy for us to, you know, just go out and shoot whenever we wanted to. Thank you.
Heroic, truly insane. Thank you so much for doing that, man. It's cold as hell. Drink some vodka, do something, man. Listen, man, definitely. You guys are heroes of the evening, man. Truly. Listen, stay tuned, man. More Night of Living Dead.
Rain.
Next up, Ben lays down the law with those nosy neighbors. Later on, Mark and Mike take a turn for the worse when they tour the darker side of Wisconsin.
Go, 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 guys. Hey, man, welcome back. Now, Mike, now hold on a second. It sounds like you have something to say.
Yeah, there are a lot of zombies here today.
Yeah, there are. And also, bringing that up, how many zombies do you think are actually in Night of Living Dead?
I would say there's 30 in the dead and more here.
Wow. Well, I'd say there's, I don't know. Let me take a wild guess and say 50.
Okay, but anyways, what do you think of this costume? Is this going to be good enough for your film? I'm the devil at this point.
Mike, you are straight Satan, man.
Okay.
Now listen, we're going to have you, I don't know if that's actually appropriate for the film, so we're going to do a couple more costume changes, and we need you guys out there to vote. Go to g4tv.com, put in your votes. As we go along, he'll change it a few costumes. We need you guys to let us know which costumes you want. And also, in your own heads, man, think about how many zombies are in Night of the Living Dead. We'll have a zombie counter. We'll figure that all out, man. So, how are you feeling, Mike?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling like more people need to be turning on their TV sets right now.
Mike, you are their best salesman, and they appreciate you for it. Why don't you show them this crazy stuff? Hey, man, let's get back to the action, man.
Don't worry about him, I can handle him.
Probably be a lot more of them as soon as they find out about us. The truck is out of gas.
This pump out here is locked. Is there a key? We can try to get out here if we can get some gas. Is there a key?
I suppose you've tried this. Do you live here?
The fact that we had a African-American in the lead was basically accident. Dwayne was the best actor from among our friends. And so if we deserve any credit, and I don't even know if it should be credit, or maybe we should have talked about it more, but we didn't change the script. We all sat down and said, well, no, just because he's black doesn't mean we shouldn't change the script. I now wonder if maybe we should have, you know, made a point out of it. But anyway, we didn't. And then because of the times, I think, and because of, you know, a lot of those factors, many of which were accidental, I think the film got a lot more attention than it would have otherwise.
Two of them out there. Have you seen any more around here? I can take care of those two.
I don't know.
I know you're afraid, but we have to.
I don't know! I don't know! What's happening?
On camera, man. Right behind us, man.
I love you, man.
Hey, you guys should be on camera. Hey, you guys should be on camera. You should put in your opinion. Hey, man, welcome back. Now, you've seen all three of Mike's costumes, and we need you to voice your opinion. Now, we've got some boisterous guys over there who I advise to get into the crowd. Which one's you? What costume do you think Mike should have?
Right here.
Which one? This one. We have a winner. Still vote, though. Go to G4TV.com and still vote, man. Still vote, man. Still vote. Call us online, man. There's a number there, man. We've got a great audience, man. And listen, again, it's very unique. At the end of Night of Living Dead, we're going to have the first ever live horror film. So you got to stay tuned for that, man. Definitely. All right, we'll be back live, man.
Things start to really heat up next, so don't go away. Plus, more Mark and Mike when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Hey, man, welcome back. Welcome back. We're all having a blast. Listen, we got a little special treat. The world premiere of my film back from 20-some years ago, Michael, Eyeball Up. I think you're going to have a kick watching this thing,
yeah,
man.
I can see it already, and I think it's going to be great.
And, I, you know, as in how it relates to Night of the Living Dead, I mean, there's some gore in Eyeball Up, and I think that's where you see the connection.
Right, yeah, there's some great things in Eyeball Up.
Absolutely. When was the last time you seen that, Mike? Okay, yeah. Here we go, man. Let's take a look. I think we're going to do some commentary. There's your boy, Ken Keene, a great man.
Cool.
Now, it seems like he's up to a little bit of mischief, though, taking a bike and then throwing it off the bridge.
Yeah, that's weird.
And there's probably moral consequences. Now, this guy seems to have some anger, some angst.
Yeah, I see.
And he seems to have done
he's
something to
shoot
the dog.
Yeah, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah,
and there's our man, Ken Keene, again. He used to live there. That was his apartment.
Right.
And so we have a little bit of metaphor with the skull.
That's cool. I swear to God, something weird just flew into my ear.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Man? It's not a mosquito. It's too cold for that, Mike.
Okay.
And excellent, man. Well, we got to get back to the film or something, man.
After that.
Listen, man, we got to take a phone. We got to do phone calls. What they would do. If they were Barb and Ben, back to it, man.
Okay.
The hell with it.
Don't look at it.
Why don't you see if you can find some wood, some boards, something there by the fireplace, something we can nail this place up.
Oh, God, that...
Look, I know you're afraid. I'm afraid, too. But we have to try to board the house up together. Now, I'm going to board up the windows and the doors. Do you understand? We'll be all right here. We'll be all right here until someone comes to rescue us. But we'll have to work together. You'll have to help me. Now, I want you to go in and get some wood so I can board the place up. Do you understand? Okay? Okay?
You know, Mike, I remember the first time that I saw this, it was at the Mill Road Library, a 16-millimeter print. We were like 14 back in 80, man. Just so spectacular and atmospheric, man. So I've got to advance the question to you. When was the first time you saw Night of the Living Dead?
I saw this about a year and a half ago. No, more than that.
Yeah, I don't think I'll buy into that, Mike.
No, maybe about 7 years and a half ago. But anyways, yeah, it just crept up on me, kind of. It was creepy, and, you know, I got this, like, eerie kind of sense or feeling that something cool is going on, you know, like it, kind of like it doesn't happen today.
Yeah, it is amazing, and that black and white is beautiful. You'll notice, you know, like motifs, like remember from Psycho with the stuffed birds, and here you have the stuffed animal on the wall. I don't know if that was a conscious decision or what. And here they are boarding up the joint.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's take a phone call, man. We've got things falling, but no phone call. We're going to continue to Yeah. Debbie.
Yeah.
Go ahead, caller. How you doing, man?
I'm great. How are you?
Great. Congratulations on your World Series win. Did you have a good time watching it?
It was awesome.
You know, Debbie, I got to admit, it is kind of weird because there's probably 100, 200 people out on a freezing Milwaukee night, and your voice is being echoed throughout this neighborhood. Congratulations.
Wow, that's crazy.
Now, let me ask you this, Debbie. What is the nature of this inquiry?
Well, I just wanted to know. I'm a really big fan of American movie, and I wanted to know if you guys are working on any other documentaries or scary movies or anything like that.
Well, we're working on Scare Me, and I think that Mike wants to add some details as we wrap this up.
Yeah, that's all right, Mike. Why don't we just move into a commercial?
Yeah, I think he was precise about that, Debbie. Have a great week, man. Thanks for the phone call. We're going to take some others, man. Yeah, like I said, we're working on Scare Me. Mike, briefly, what are you working on? Hit him and hit him hard.
Debbie, didn't mean to cut you off, but we wanted to just say that we're having a rocking time out here, and we hope that you're rocking your world back in St. Louis.
Thank you, Mike. We'll take more phone calls. We'll be back, man, live.
Up next, Ben shows us some handy zombie prevention tips, and the countdown continues to the first ever live horror film.
Excellent, man. Welcome back. Now, I got to reiterate, at the end of Night of the Living Dead, we are doing a live horror film, but what we do need is a title. Now, we have to attempt to extract that title from our live audience. Is that correct, Mike and Kate?
Yeah. Does anybody out here have a title?
Steel Reserve Zombies.
Okay, that's quite specific, man. We're gonna. We're getting closer, man. Who's got a title idea?
Night of the Popsicle Zombies.
Excellent. We're humor, Rick, please.
Blood excellent.
Cheese Zombies.
We're getting close, man. We're getting.
We'll work around
zombie attack. Here we got something.
Oh, Mark, I've got one. No crackers for Polly.
I don't know what to say. Listen, man. There's a surprise coming up, man, in the next act of Night of Living Dead. I just wanted to get that in there, man.
I'm sorry. I just wanted to get my title in. Brain Dead Cheeseheads.
Excellent. All right, that's insane. That's great, man. Vote online for that title, g4tv.com. And you guys are great, man. Stay with us live.
Not that strong. Here, I want you to pick out some nails. Pick out the biggest ones you can find. Yeah, this room looks pretty secure. If we have to, we can run in here and board up the doors. Won't be long before those things will be back pounding their way in here. They're afraid now. They're afraid of fire. I found that out. place back down the road called Beekman's. Beekman's Diner. Anyhow, that's where I found that truck I have out there. There's a radio in the truck. I jumped in to listen to it when a big gasoline truck came screaming right across the road. But there must have been 10, 15 of those things chasing after it, grabbing and holding on. Now, I didn't see them at first. I could just see that the truck was moving in a funny way. And those things were catching up to it. Right across the road. Slammed on my brakes to keep from hitting it myself. It went right through the guardrail. I guess the driver must have cut off the road into that gas station by Beekman's Diner. It went right through the billboard, ripped over a gas pump, and never stopped moving. By now it's like a moving bonfire.
Didn't know if the truck was going to explode or what. Still hear the man screaming. This thing is just backing away from it. I looked back at the diner to see if there was anyone there who could help me. That was when I noticed that the entire place had been encircled. There wasn't a sign of life left except. By now there were no more screams. I realized that I was alone with 50 or 60 of those things just standing there, staring at me. I started to drive. I just plowed right through them. They didn't move. They didn't run or just stood there staring at me. Just wanted to crush them. They scattered through the air like bugs.
We were riding in the cemetery, Johnny and me. Johnny. We came to put a wreath on my father's grave. Johnny, and he said, "Can I have some candy, Barbara?" We didn't have any. And oh, it's hot in here. Hot. And he said, "Oh, it's late. Why did we start so late?" And I said, "Johnny, if you'd gotten up earlier, we wouldn't be late." Johnny asked me if I were afraid. And I said, "I'm not afraid, Johnny." And then this man started walking up the road. He came slowly, and Johnny kept teasing me and saying, "He's coming to get you, Barbara." And I laughed at him and said, "Johnny, stop it." And then Johnny ran away. And I went up to this man, and I was going to apologize.
"Why don't you just keep calm?"
And I looked up, and I said, "Good evening." And he grabbed me. He grabbed me, and he ripped at me. He held me, and he ripped at my clothes.
I think you should just calm down.
Oh, I screamed, "Johnny! Johnny, help me! Oh, help me!" And he came and he ran and he fought this man. And I got so afraid. I ran. And Johnny didn't come. We have to wait for Johnny. Better go out and get him. We have to go out and get Johnny. He's out there. Please, don't you hear me? We've got to go out and get him. Please, we have got to go get Johnny. Please help me. Please.
Look, don't you know what's going on out there? This is no Sunday school picnic.
Don't you understand? My brother is alone.
Your brother is dead.
No! My brother is not dead!
Man, that was some crazy toy action. Well, we got four titles to vote from. We're gonna knock this out real quick. Zombie Attack.
Night of the Unholy Raid, No Crackers for Polly.
And Brain Dead Cheeseheads.
And Uh-Oh. And now to our resident lesbian actor, you'll recognize him from Coven, none other than Robert Richard George. Take it away, sir.
Borat attacks G4 this Friday with all the info on Budman Sacha Baron Cohen and his new film, Borat. Oh, the hour special kicks off with a must-see half-hour attack of the show, featuring all exclusive interview with Borat himself and Forrest from a packed house of fans from the first public showing in L.A. Oh, and then a brand new icon. Sacha Baron Cohen goes deep inside the mind of this controversial comedian. Oh, check it out Friday night on G4. And now, there's much more going on in Menomonee Falls, Wisconsin, so don't go away!
Ben reveals his magic burning chair trick, and there's still time to come on down and make zombie movie history when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Never move!
Tenacious D in the Pick of Destiny. This film is not yet rated. Starts Wednesday, November 22nd.
Back. It'll be there in the morning.
The all-new Mazda CX-7. The SUV you never saw coming. It all comes back to.
From the fields of glory where Saturday afternoon legends are born, to the pageantry and passion, it's time for college football. Now you can bring that passion and pride home with Fathead. So put away that foam finger and slap up a Fathead. With schools from all the big-time college football powerhouses, Fathead wall graphics are classic collectibles made for only real fans. It's easy to put up. Just peel and place in any home or office. Fathead can take a hit. Printed on strong, durable vinyl, Fathead is the only wall graphic that actually lets you move it over and over again all season long.
Looks like this little fella's ready.
So big and real, you can't find them in a store. There's only one place to get them. Fathead.com. Officially licensed by the Collegiate Licensing Company, NASCAR, the NBA, the NFL, and Players Inc. Fathead.com, where you can also find all your favorite players and teams. Call or go online at Fathead.com today. Check out our special season pricing and be the ultimate fan of your team. Fathead, go big, real big.
We now return to Night of the Living Dead, live from Wisconsin.
Welcome back to Wisconsin, where we are live, and we are going to do a live horror film at the end, Mike. But you know what? We don't have any props to kill the zombies with, man, for this live film. Yeah. What do you suggest, Michael?
I suggest we walk up to the convenience store down the street. Come on, let's go.
Now, hold on, Mike. I think I'm going to have to put on this hat. Like that. And let's go find a weapon, man.
Right.
Absolutely.
Weapon? Now, I had a couple of things in mind.
Yeah, look, mouse traps.
Strangling with a shoelace. It makes killing zombies a breeze.
Knock them out with some marshmallow fluff. It's not a joke, man.
Do you have any interest in killing zombies? You look like a pretty violent person, and we were hoping that maybe you could help us.
I'm just here for spice. But...
Really? You're not trying to kill anyone?
Hey, man, maybe we could kill them with pop culture monotony.
Well, I'm sure you've killed plenty more zombies than the two of us put together.
Been here Mike, look at this.
Well, yeah, but
Mike,
this one says...
calm down. Bug spray, dude. Now, what about this rolling pin?
Well, I don't know.
I do.
Look at that,
stuff,
man.
I know they don't like it.
Stabbing with
yeah.
that.
Well, what has your life been like, Mark?
Well, it says it's ups and downs, but it's always giving me a fair shake. I have to assume likewise.
My life has never had any ups and downs. It's always just been kind of at a low, real low, distant, kind of foggy, scary, spooky level.
Holy cannoli!
Yeah, that
hey,
we
Mike,
have.
Look at this.
Well, you know, Mark, the Wall of China wasn't built in a day. I wonder what it's like to do really well at something. Pull the most common sense value to kill a zombie with.
Big block of cheese and do the trick.
That sounds good.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
And give it your roll. And action.
All right.
My God, it works. And that'll be it. Come on, give the dude 20 bucks and let's go.
I don't have 20 bucks.
Well, can I get a free sticker? Listen, man, again, I want to say you did a really swell job.
Okay, well.
And I appreciate your adamance and stick-to-itiveness in getting the job done. A lot of people would have fell out in that store.
Oh, you.
Excellent.
Wow, well, we really got some good props. Hey, I got an idea, Mike.
Mike, you ought to be talking over here. I think we did well, man.
I got an idea, Mark. Why don't we have the audience at home vote on which prop they like the best? We got a hammer. We got a hacksaw.
Now, wait a second. I don't have a tetanus shot, dude. Thank you so much.
And we have
this
a block
look
of
effective,
cheese.
Man.
I like the block of cheese.
Excellent. Now, do we have something else here, too?
Yeah, two empty plastic bags.
And allegedly a rolling pin. So we have these four items to choose. Hold up the rolling pin that ain't existing.
I think...
block of cheese, man. Hacksaw. Get your tetanus shots, man.
And a rolling pin that doesn't exist.
And a hammer, man. Now, you guys got to vote. And whatever you guys pick, we'll use to kill the zombie, man.
All
so
right.
Please,
I like
man.
The cheese.
Do you?
Yeah.
Look at that, man. Who knows? Yep. Who knows, man?
And will we ever...
Listen, we got to get back to business. Live.
Because of the obvious threat to untold numbers of citizens, and because of the crisis which is even now developing, this radio station will remain on the air day and night. This station and hundreds of other radio and TV stations throughout this part of the country are pooling their resources through an emergency network hookup to keep you informed of all developments. At this hour, we repeat, these are the facts as we know them. There is an epidemic of mass murder being committed by a virtual army of unidentified assassins. The murders are taking place in villages, cities, rural homes, and suburbs with no apparent pattern or reason for the slayings. It seems to be a sudden, general explosion of mass homicide. We have some descriptions of the assassins. Eyewitnesses say they are ordinary-looking people. Some say they appear to be in a kind of trance. Others describe them as being...
Excellent, man. So listen, we've got a mission and we've got a friend, man. We have to figure out the most effective way to kill these zombies and how can we kill them with these props. Mike, you want to ask this person that question?
Yeah, hacksaw.
Nah. Hammer. No. How about cheese? Cheese, that's my vote. Excellent choice, and how would you kill him with this block of cheese, sir?
Shove it down his throat.
Excellent. Well, that's going to have to be a large throat, man. You guys are great. Well, we gotta figure out, man. You guys got to vote, man. We got to figure out how to kill this zombie for our very first live film. And here we have another gentleman. How are you doing?
Pretty good.
Excellent. Subtly said, man. Listen, what kind of weapon would you use?
Hammer, hacksaw?
I'd use a hammer.
Why would you use a hammer?
Hit it right in the head.
Excellent. Well, that's effective, man.
But what about the rolling pin that we lost?
Yeah, what about the rolling pin we lost from the convenience store over here? Where did that go? Any idea?
I have no idea.
Excellent. And you?
I don't know.
Excellent, man. That's a very truthful answer. Well, this is very exciting, man, and we got to have your input. How are we going to kill these zombies in our very, very live film, man? You guys are great and beautiful.
From National Press Services in Washington, D.C., now tells us that the emergency presidential conference, which we've just mentioned, will include high-ranking scientists from the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. That's the extent of this latest conference meeting. Their facilities and an emergency network to bring you this news as it develops. We urge you to stay tuned to radio and TV and to stay indoors at all costs. Late reports reaching this newsroom tell of frightened people seeking refuge in churches, schools, and government buildings, demanding shelter and protection from the wholesale murder which apparently is engulfing much of the nation.
Written a short story which basically I ripped off from Richard Matheson's novel I Am Legend, and which is about the last man on earth and vampires have taken over the planet. And so I couldn't use vampires because Richard did, and I didn't want to make it. His story starts with only one man left, and I thought, well, if I wanted to do something about revolution, the same sort of thing that he was talking about, but I wanted to sort of start it at the beginning on the very first night that it happened.
North and west. Our newsmen have been on the telephone talking with officials in other cities and have determined that none of this kind of mass murder has yet been reported west of the Mississippi River.
Hey, we're back live in Wisconsin and there's much, much more to come. The natives, they are restless, man. That's crazy.
Up next, the movie continues to drag on, and we'll see if the neighbors have a bone to pick with Mark and Mike as they prepare for their live movie.
Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge.
On the beanie weenie piddly diddly poof.
Happy Feet, rated PG, in theaters and IMAX November 17th.
Who am I?
很快
Multiply your possibilities. Introducing Intel Core 2 Duo, the world's best processors.
For the first time ever, the world's largest army of superheroes is under your control. Don't blow it. Marvel Ultimate Alliance, rated T for teen.
Experience history's battles like never before. A series that places you right in the combat. Dogfights, like a video game, but deadlier. A new series, as only the History Channel can bring you. Check your local listings.
Unleash the power of Robo-Reptile. Robo-Reptile claims his territory, stalking his prey with biomorphic bursts of speed. Part reptile, part technology, all attitude. Robo-Reptile, a fusion of technology and personality. Batteries not included. From Wowee.
We now join our irregularly scheduled program. Night of the Living Dead, live from Wisconsin.
Hey, man, we got something special, man. While they're taking care of business in Night of the Living Dead at the farmhouse, we have a special musical interlude by none other than Mike and Kate. You're going to enjoy this.
Eastern portion of Texas. Similar killings have been reported around the Houston and Galveston areas, but nothing like...
I found a gun and some bullets out there.
It was only late yesterday...
Oh, and these.
...it became clear we were facing some kind of national emergency. When first reports began filtering in, newsmen and law enforcement agencies were of the opinion...
This place is boarded up pretty solid now. We ought to be all right here for a while. We have the gun and bullets, food and the radio. Sooner or later, someone's bound to come and get us out.
Creatures from outer space. So again, we join with law enforcement agencies urging you to seek shelter in a building. Lock the doors and windows securely.
Hey, that's us. We're doing all right.
Cautious of any suspicious strangers. And keep tuned to your radio and television for survival instructions and further details of this continuing story.
Look, I don't know if you're hearing me. But I'm going upstairs now.
It's almost as though some critical balance
of... If anything should try to break in here, I can hear it from up there. I'll be down to take care of it.
We repeat, this radio station...
Everything is all right for now. I'll be back to reinforce the windows and doors later. But you'll be all right for now, okay? Okay.
Civil defense officials in Cumberland have told newsmen that murder victims show evidence of having been partially devoured by their murderers.
Thank you.
the effect that people who acted as though they were in a kind of trance were killing and eating their victims prompted authorities to examine the bodies of some of the victims. Medical authorities in Cumberland have concluded that in all cases, the killers are eating the flesh of the people they murdered. Repeating this latest bulletin just received moments ago from Cumberland, Maryland, civil defense authorities have told newsmen that murder victims show evidence of having been partially devoured by their murderers. Medical examination of victims' bodies shows conclusively that the killers are eating the flesh of the people they kill. And so this incredible story becomes more ghastly with each report. It's difficult to imagine such a thing actually happening, but these are the reports we have been receiving and passing on to you, reports which have been verified as completely as is possible in this confused situation. It is happening, and it would appear that no one is safe from this wave of mass murder.
Hey guys, congratulations on your musical accomplishment. Mike, you too, man.
Yeah, thanks.
Beautiful stuff. Listen, do not go away. There is more mayhem coming up, man.
When G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues, we'll see if the boys can survive some hand-to-hand-to-hand-to-hand combat. And Mike shares a chilling tale, sure to scare the shank out of you.
They were ordinary people, unsuspecting, innocent victims. Meet the man behind it all.
You're a piece of garbage. You owe me the money. John, run through. You said that we could do this to the house.
I know you. This is on camera.
Jamie Kennedy is back, and no one is safe.
You've been axed.
No!
The Jamie Kennedy Experiment, weeknights at 6, only on G4.
Craziest head I know is gonna be a fed.
On November 10th.
The one boy!
Harsh times call for harsh measures.
I'm a soldier of the apocalypse.
Are you gonna be happy once he's dead?
Harsh times. Rated R. In theaters November 10th.
Introducing the new Family Value Meal from Pizza Hut. Start with two medium pizzas topped any way you want them. Add breadsticks and cinnamon sticks and a 2 liter of Pepsi, all for $19.99. You always get more when you go for the good stuff.
We have been testing the new Chic Quattro Titanium to see if it really is off the easy.
3, 2, 1.
With 4 advanced blades, Quattro Titanium stays sharp to give you a close, smooth shave with less irritation.
New Chic Quattro Titanium.
He came from nothing and redefined the American dream.
I buried those cockroaches!
His enemies wanted him dead.
Say hello to my little friend!
But Tony Montana doesn't die that easy. Tony's back. Scarface, the world is yours. Rated M for mature.
Every dog curses today.
Wield their powers. Feel their fury. Fight for justice. When the world needs heroes, no one else is in their league. Justice League Heroes. Rated T.
So, where do you think this guy should move?
I'd say this way. And let's make sure that sound effect we used in the last level fits in here, too.
This one?
Yeah.
You know, I'm so glad I got into game design. It's cool to be able to create the kind of games that we play.
I know what you mean. And the training at Collins College takes less time than most people might think.
Can you believe we get paid to do this?
For a complimentary DVD, call 888-823-0999. Operators are standing by. That's 888-823-0999. Call now.
I found something really, really big that's really, really small. It's the Massively Mini Media Player. You can drag and drop your favorite music, download tons of free videos from tigertube.com, or even download a video you created. And it has a built-in radio so you can listen to and record music. Good things really do come in massively mini packages.
It's the Massively Mini Media Player.
Each sold separately. Ask your parents' permission before going online.
You can look for Hillary CD in stores now.
On November 17th, G4 takes you inside one of the most anticipated launches in gaming history. PS3 Day 1, November 17th, only on G4.
Just when you thought it was safe to turn on your TV, it's Mark and Mike. Welcome back.
Hey, Mike, man, we're making this live film, but we need some blood effects.
Right.
So, yeah, we're going to have to find some unwilling victims. No, willing
okay.
victims. Be wow. serious, Mike. To experiment with these fake blood tricks, okay, man?
That's cool.
So this is what we're going to need to do, man. So hang tight, and we'll figure it out when we get back, man. Sound good to you?
Sounds good to me.
Call it! Don't shoot! We're from town. A radio.
County, Pennsylvania. The Butler County Sheriff has verified that reports of murder victims being partially eaten by their slayers is true. No further details available at this time. However,
how long have you guys been down there? I could use some help up here.
That's the cellar. It's the safest place.
You mean you didn't hear the racket we were making up here?
How were we supposed to know what was going on? Could have been those things for all we knew.
That girl was screaming. Sure, you must know what a girl screaming sounds like. Those things don't make any noise. Anybody would know somebody ever needed help.
Look, it's kind of hard to hear what's going on from down there. We thought we could hear screams, but for all we knew, that could have meant those things were in the house after her.
And you wouldn't come up and help.
Well, if there were more,
the racket sounded like the place was being ripped apart. How were we supposed to know what was going on?
Now, wait a minute. You just got finished saying you couldn't hear from down there. Now you say it sounded like the place was being ripped apart. It would be nice if you get your story straight, man.
All right, now you tell me. I'm not going to take that kind of a chance when we got a safe place. We luck into a safe place, and you're telling us we got to risk our lives just because somebody might need help, huh?
Yeah, something like that.
All right, why don't we settle this, Mister? We came up. Okay, we're here. Now I suggest we all go back downstairs before any of those things find out we're in here.
They can't get in here.
You got the whole place boarded up?
Yeah, most of it. All but a few spots upstairs. They won't be hard to fix.
You're insane. The cellar's the safest place.
I'm telling you, they can't get in here.
And I'm telling you, those things turned over our car. We were damn lucky to get away at all. Now you tell me those things can't get through this lousy pile of wood?
His wife and kids downstairs. The kids hurt.
Well, I still think we're better off up here.
We could strengthen everything up, Mr. Cooper.
With all of us working, we could fix this place up in no time. We have everything we need up here.
We can take all that stuff downstairs with us. Man, you're really crazy, you know that? You got a million windows up here. All these windows, you're gonna make them strong enough to keep these things out, huh?
I told you, those things don't have any strength. I smashed three of them and pushed another one out the door.
Did you hear me when I told you they turned over our car?
Oh, hell, any good 5 men can do that.
That's my point. Only there's not going to be 5 or even 10. There's going to be 20, 30, maybe 100 of those things. And as soon as they know we're here, this place is going to be crawling with them.
Well, if they're that many, they'll probably get us wherever we are.
Look, the cellar. The cellar, there's only one door, right? Just one door, that's all we have to protect. Tom and I fixed it so it locks and boards from the inside. But up here, all these windows, why, we'd never know where they were going to hit us next.
You got a point, Mr. Cooper. But down in the cellar, there's no place to run to. I mean, if they did get in, there'd be no back exit. We'd be done for. We can get out of here if we have to. And we got windows to see what's going on outside. But down there with no windows, if a rescue party did come, we wouldn't even know it.
But the cellar is the strongest place.
The cellar is a death trap.
I don't know, Mr. Cooper. I think he's right. You know how many's out there?
I don't know. Maybe 6 or 7.
Look, you two can do whatever you like. I'm going back down to the cellar, and you better decide. Because I'm going to board up that door, and I'm not going to unlock it again, no matter what happens.
Now, wait a minute, Mr. Cooper.
No, I'm not going to wait. I've made my decision, now you make yours.
Now, wait a minute. Let's think about this. We can make it to the cellar if we have to. And if we do decide to stay down there, we'll need some things from up here. So let's at least consider this a while.
If you box yourself in the cellar and those things get in the house, you've had it. At least up here you have a fighting chance.
Yeah, it looks like about 8 or 10 of them now.
That's more than there were. There are a lot out back, too.
Thank you.
Man, I think it was fantastic. Yeah, like, this blood work is perfect, man. You guys look great. What do you think, man?
I wanted more.
Yeah.
Ooh, great.
Yeah.
More.
Yeah, you girls are great sports. And,
get a little bit more bloody, Mike. Absolutely, man. Thank you very much, man.
Yeah.
You guys are great. It's going to work. You're fantastic, man. Thank you. Thank you, man. Beautiful live, man. Keep watching.
Don't go away or you'll miss the world's biggest Beatle fan while Mark and Mike take a stab at creating Halloween history. Go to G4TV.com. Always fresh, always new, always plugged in. Coming up later, a sneak peek of Tenacious D and the Pick of Destiny, starring Jack Black and Kyle Gass, in theaters November 22nd.
JB was born to rock.
Gotta get it on in the party zone.
KG was meant to shine.
It's with the hat, dude.
When they came together.
Oh. I've had this birthmark since I was born.
It was destiny.
It's the name of our band, dude.
Jack Black, Kyle Gass.
Give me that remote.
Tenacious D in the Pick of Destiny. This film is not yet rated. Starts Wednesday, November 22nd.
All I'm saying is you can tell a lot about someone from their car.
No, I don't know what you're saying.
I mean, take this one. Leather seats, nav system, Bose surround sound. This guy is the man.
Introducing the 244-horsepower turbocharged Mazda CX-7. The SUV you never saw coming.
The man. Yeah, you're the man.
What?
The all-new Mazda CX-7. It all comes back to him.
What do you think of this new Stride?
Ridiculous. Long-lasting government. Frank's business.
Stride is it? Yeah!
So Brad in accounting says to me, if the flavor lasts so long, won't we sell less gum?
What a moron.
Maybe Brad was right.
Maybe the flavor does last too long.
New Stride, the ridiculously long-lasting gum. Good for you, bad for us.
Papa's back with a brand new bag of tricks.
Crypto's back to unleash a devastating new arsenal of alien weapons and mental abilities. Team up with a friend and destroy all humans together. Destroy all humans too. Rated G. In stores now.
Country Giants Week continues. She was married at age 13, yet Loretta Lynn was anything but conventional.
She really changed what women could sing about.
Then, more women who dare to break the Nashville mold. Loretta Lynn and Mavericks, Honky Tonk Angels. Tomorrow, beginning at 8, on the Biography Channel.
Hilo, Hawaii. On a rainy night, an island woman died mysteriously. Hilo erupted into allegations of corruption, cover-up, and murder.
City Confidential. Tomorrow at 10, only on the Biography Channel.
Experience history's battles like never before.
Here you are, one-on-one. Kill or be killed. Pow, hit him right in the middle.
A series that uses state-of-the-art animation to place you right in the middle of the combat.
You saw such incredible kill rates.
Dogfights, like a video game, but deadlier. A new series, Fridays at 10, as only the History Channel can bring you. And now, back to the boys who put the sin in Wisconsin, Mark and Mike.
Hey, man, welcome back. Hey, it was wild. They were being attacked, but there really wasn't any screaming. That's crazy. We need screaming for our zombie film. So we're going to do a little quick audition here. Now, Mike's a master screamer. But well, let's see what the boys here got, man. Sounds like Robert, Richard, George, and me. Good shot! Hey! Welcome back, man! Excellent!
gotta fix these boards.
You're crazy. Those things are gonna be in every window and door in this place. We've got to get down into the cellar.
Go down in that damn cellar. Get out of here!
I'm taking the girl with me.
You leave her here. Keep your hands off her. And everything else that's up here, too. Because if I stay up here, I'm fighting for everything up here. And the radio and the food is part of what I'm fighting for. Now, if you're going down the cellar, get.
The man's insane. He's insane. We've got to have food down there. We've got a right.
This is your house.
We've got a right.
You going down there with him?
Well,
yes or no, this is your last chance. No beating around the bush.
Listen, I got a kid down there. She can't possibly, I couldn't bring her up here. She can't possibly take all the racket and those things smashing through the windows.
Well, you're her father. If you're stupid enough to go die in that trap, that's your business. However, I am not stupid enough to follow you. It is tough for the kid that old man is so stupid. Now, you get the hell down in the cellar. You can be the boss down there. I'm boss up here.
You bastards. You know, I won't open this door again. I mean it. Mr. Cooper, with your help, we could...
With my help.
Let him go, man. His mind is made up. Just let him go.
Wait a minute. Judy, come on up here, honey. You're going to let them get hurt, too, huh? It's all right, honey. Go ahead. Together, man, we can fix it up real good. There are lots of places we can run to up here. Mr. Cooper, we'd all be a lot better off if the four of us were working together.
Hey. Hey, kid.
He's wrong, you know. I'm not boxing myself in down there.
Day and night. Well, we're safe now. It's boarded up tight.
What about Tom and Judy?
They want to stay up there, let them. There are two other people upstairs, a man and a girl.
We heard you screaming.
Yeah, but I didn't know who they were, and I wasn't about to take any unnecessary chances.
Of course not, Harry.
Is she all right?
I don't know what it is. She feels warm. Maybe it's shock.
Where'd you get the bandage?
Some laundry in a basket. I tore a sheet.
Let them stay upstairs. Let them. Too many ways those monsters can get in up there. We'll see who's right. We'll see. When they come begging me to let them in down here.
That's important, isn't it?
What?
To be right, everybody else to be wrong.
What do you mean by that?
Does anyone up there know why we're being attacked?
Whatever it isn't just happening here. It's some kind of mass murder. It's going on everywhere. The radio said to stay inside.
Radio?
Radio upstairs. I heard a news bulletin.
There's a radio upstairs and you boarded us in down here?
I know what I'm doing.
What did it say?
Nothing. Nothing. They don't know anything yet. There's mass murder everywhere and people are supposed to look for a safe place to hide.
Take the boards off that door.
We are staying down here, Helen.
Harry, that radio is at least some kind of communication. If the authorities know what's happening, well, they'll send people for us or they'll tell us what to do. How are we going to know what's going on if we lock ourselves in this dungeon? We may not enjoy living together, but dying together isn't going to solve anything. Those people aren't our enemies.
Mr. Cooper! Mr. Cooper, Ben found the television set upstairs.
Okay.
Let's go up.
Tom?
Yes?
If Judy would come downstairs for a few minutes, Harry and I could come upstairs.
Okay, yeah, right away.
November 12th, the Tenacious D movie comes out. Pick a destiny. Happy Halloween, you guys. Here's some Tenacious D guitar picks as when you guys scream.
Gathered around the TV to watch the gang gather around the TV, and don't look now, but rehearsals are about to begin for Mark's historic film when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Friday, Borat attacks G4.
Yes, it's true.
Join Kevin and Olivia at the first public screening of the most anticipated film of the year. It's Attack of the Show, Borat. Catch exclusive interviews, fan reactions, and a few surprises. Then, go deep inside the genius behind Borat with an all-new icon, Sacha Baron Cohen. Catch Attack of the Show, Borat, starting at 7, followed by an all-new Icons, Friday, only on G4.
Has a new address. A place where bad things don't just happen at night. The best horror, the most deranged killers, all just waiting for you. To get there, go to fearnet.com. Come on, what are you afraid of?
RoboSapien V2, pre-release testing online. Range of motion and dexterity, commence.
I hope nobody saw that. I am Wowie Robotics Marvel RS2.
RoboSapien V2, a fusion of technology and personality. Batteries not included from Wowie.
Who's your daddy?
Available now at these fine retailers.
This Friday.
What kind of music you listen to?
I like very much Corky Butcher. Bing bong, bing bong, bing bing bong.
Get down with
Borat.
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 Like it up.
Yeah.
But don't show your huggies, man.
Rated R. Friday.
There's a better way to phone for less.
Sweet, bought it.
Unlimited local and long distance calling, just $24.99 a month. And a savings of up to 50% on your phone bill.
Come on, let's go pay.
On each one smart decision among many, many stupid ones. Call 1-800-930-4DON.
Hair lacking muscle? Can't take another break? Garnier Fructis, the first fortifying system with the power of active fruit concentrate from Garnier, makes hair 5 times stronger, so it never takes a break. Garnier Fructis.
Garnier.
Welcome back to Halloween, Wisconsin style. Here's Mark and Mike.
Man, dude, that was the greatest scream, and I want to thank you, man. And hey, man, we got to get back to Night of the Living Dead live here from Wisconsin, man. It's just a great time, Mike. And you with me, Mike?
Yeah.
Beautiful, man. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Will you do it?
Do I have to?
Look, honey, nothing's going to get done with them down there and us up here. Do this for me.
Okay.
Okay, open up.
Good stuff.
Chris, we're going to need some more soon.
Her brother was killed.
Hey, give me a hand with this thing.
I gotta go help Ben with the television.
Yeah. It's very gratifying to have all this attention and have, you know, Night of the Living Dead be in the National Film Archive, and of course it's wonderful, you know, but it doesn't affect your life in a certain sense, you know. It's like I'm still just trying to think about what am I gonna do tomorrow.
Don't be afraid of me. I'm Helen Cooper, Harry's wife.
This place is ridiculous. Look at this. There's a million weak spots up here. Give me one of those.
Her brother was killed.
And they talk about these windows. I can't see a damn thing. There could be 50 million of those things out there. That's how much good these windows are.
Why don't you do something to help somebody?
Here, I have it. Drag a couple of those chairs together.
There's a socket over here. You better watch this and try to understand what's going on. I don't want anyone's life on my hands.
Is there anything I can do to help?
I don't want to hear any more from you, mister. If you stay up here, you take orders from me. And that includes leaving the girl alone.
It's on. It's on. There's no sound. Play with the rabbit ears.
Reports, incredible as they seem, are not the results of mass hysteria.
Mass hysteria. What do they think? We're imagining all this?
Shut up!
In all parts of the country. The wave of murder which is sweeping the eastern third of the nation is being committed by creatures who feast upon the flesh of their victims. First eyewitness accounts of this grisly development came from people who were understandably frightened and almost incoherent. Officials and newsmen at first discounted those eyewitness descriptions as being beyond belief. However, the reports persisted. Medical examinations of some of the victims bore out the fact that they had been partially devoured. I think we have some late word of just arriving, and I'll interrupt to bring this to you. This is the latest disclosure in a report from National Civil Defense Headquarters in Washington. It has been established that persons who have recently died have been returning to life and committing acts of murder. Widespread investigation of reports from funeral homes, morgues, and hospitals has concluded that the unburied dead are coming back to life and seeking human victims. It's hard for us here to believe what we're reporting to you, but it does seem to be a fact. When this emergency first began, radio and television was advising people to stay inside, behind locked doors for safety. Well, that situation has now changed. We're able to report a definite course of action for you. Civil defense machinery has been organized to provide rescue stations with food, shelter, medical treatment, and protection by armed National Guardsmen. Stay tuned to the broadcasting stations in your local area for this list of rescue stations. This list will be repeated throughout our news coverage. Look for the name of the rescue station nearest you and make your way to that location as soon as possible.
So we have that truck. We can get some gas. We can get out of here.
There's a pump out by the shed.
I know, that's why I pulled in here, but it's locked.
Wow, I'm really having a great time out here, dude. Thanks a lot for inviting me.
So am I, Mike, and I was just about to say, well, these guys there out in Night of the Living Dead TV land are gathered on the TV for their information. So are we, and we've got some voting to do, some figuring out to do, a title of the film, what costume Mike's going to wear,
and what weapon we're going to use to kill the zombies, man.
I like the cheese.
Live, a live film, man.
I like the cheese.
I'm glad you do.
Don't you move or you'll miss little Karen's only line in the entire film. And you'll be hurt if you miss Mike and Mark's haunted tour coming up next. When G4's Night of the Living Dead screening...
Welcome to the source for all the things you care about.
I love this show every frickin' day.
Attack of the Show, weeknights at 7 only on G4.
Brought to you by Mountain Dew. Coming to you live and in color.
He came from nothing and redefined the American dream.
I buried those cockroaches!
His enemies wanted him dead.
Say hello to my little friend!
But Tony Montana doesn't die that easy. Scarface, the world is yours. Rated M for Mature.
Every dog curses today.
I can give you what you want. I can make your heart beat short. I can make you ice cream. We can be a sweet tea melting in your ice cream.
Multiply your possibilities.
I can give you what you want.
Introducing Intel Core 2 Duo, the world's best processors.
I got nothing.
Don't worry about it.
Cindy, I'm home.
Dad!
Warning, the makers of Tag Wildcard remind you that if you mess with the King's Queens, you better watch your ace, Jack.
Tag Wildcard. Consider yourself warned.
Every pack of Magic the Gathering comes with 15 cards. And millions of players. Find them at playmagic.com.
We're back. Now, here are Mark and Mike live from Wisconsin.
Whoa.
Hey, man, welcome back live from Wisconsin. I mean, this is an incredible night, Mike. And, Kate,
yeah.
We're glad that you're joining us again, man.
Thank you. Yeah,
listen.
Sorry you bit your tongue.
No, it's, you know, it's nothing, really.
Are you okay?
Oh, yeah, of course I'm fine.
Okay.
Excellent. Excellent. Listen, man. Mike, we are, Kate as well, we are about to make a live history with the first ever live horror film. We've got at least 50 zombies out here. We've got people working in the kitchen, preparing stuff. I mean, this is just great, Mike.
Yeah, we have people voting.
Yes, we do, man.
Yeah.
And I, again, man, it's live, the first ever horror film. I think we're going to have a blast, man.
Right.
And, I mean, the people here, the energy.
So,
look, man, we got to get back to the movie, man. Right?
Right.
This afternoon by the president. Since convening this conference of the presidential cabinet, the FBI, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, CIA has not produced any public information. Why are space experts being consulted about an earthbound emergency? So far, all the betting on the answer to that question centers on the recent Explorer satellite shot to Venus. That satellite, you recall, started back to Earth, but never got here. That's the space vehicle which orbited Venus and then was purposely destroyed by NASA when scientists discovered it was carrying a mysterious high-level radiation with it. Could that radiation be somehow responsible for the wholesale murders we're now suffering? Newsman Don Quinn in Washington has posed those questions.
It's obvious our best move is to try to get out of here.
How are you going to get over to that pump?
Look!
You're coming from a meeting regarding the explosion of the Venus probe, is that right, sir?
Yes, that was the subject of the meeting.
Do you feel there is a connection between this and the phenomenon?
There's a definite connection, a definite connection.
In other words, you feel that the radiation on the Venus probe is enough to cause these mutations?
There was a very high degree of radiation.
Well, just a minute. I'm not sure that that's certain at all. I don't think that has been
logical irrefutable explanation that we have at this time.
In other words, it is the military's viewpoint that the radiation is not the cause of the mutation.
I can't speak for the entire military at this time, gentlemen.
Mark. So I'm sure like they used to be. Hey, Mike, you know, that's Romero right there. He's tall. He's actually in this film. Really?
Yeah, he's doing the, he's got a microphone in his hand.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, this is an incredible scene, man. The dread is growing in the film. And it's just beautiful. I think here we're in Washington, D.C. right now, a little break away from the nightmare in the farmhouse. You know what's amazing, Mike? It's actually a sense of relief for a while to escape the claustrophobia of terror.
Uh-huh, yeah, it's an incredible moment in time.
Absolutely, man. And I think, though, just like with any terror, I mean, you get this little break, and then we're going to get right back into it. We have some denial, maybe, going on right here, microphones, so on and so forth. And we'll see what happens next, man. And there they speed off, man, into the unknown, so to speak. Back into the terror, Mike. Doesn't that blow your mind?
Yeah, it sure does, Mark.
Real people in this incredibly disastrous situation.
Yeah. And they seem like such real situations, too.
Well, it is. I mean, the living dead. I mean, that's a situation you got to deal with on a daily basis, man. They were in the newsroom. So it is amazing, man, because it could happen at any time.
Yeah, too bad we couldn't jump in and save the day.
Well, what could we offer that they couldn't? These are very logical-minded
people,
Mike.
Well, we could offer a big block of cheese.
You're right, man. And we'll see what actually happens in our film, man.
Okay.
Excellent, man. When was the last time you saw this, Mike?
Oh, 1979.
Well, now that's a pretty accurate memory. Are you sure that wasn't the first time?
Well, it could have been.
Right, Mike, I think we're resorting now to a little bit of goofism, don't you think?
Yeah, maybe.
Exactly, I'm sure I saw it with you maybe a few years ago. Maybe I'm making up, but I don't know, man. But this is interesting, man, you know, they had to create a set for this.
Yeah. I like the selection of the names and stuff like that.
Yeah, that was interesting that you brought up that little detail.
Oh, they're actually real names of cities or
centers where they can go, you know, for revenue.
Yeah.
You know, Mike,
did they ever get there?
I don't know, Mike, but I got to say this. I, too, was fascinated by those names. It just added something to it, man.
It's like, they seem like such ordinary names, like such as a name of a city that would be in Wisconsin.
Yeah, absolutely. And Pennsylvania does, where this takes place, has the same feel as Wisconsin, that rural mystique.
Yeah, here's a recreation center on East Brady Street. We have Brady Street in Milwaukee that's on the east side.
And I want to thank you for pointing that out, Mike.
Yeah.
Excellent. Now listen, man, that's Kyra Schoen. She's the little girl.
Okay, well anyways, I think...
it's time to move on, man.
Yeah,
definitely.
So. Yeah,
man. Well, you're a great host, Mike.
Thank you, Judy.
The body should be disposed of at once, preferably by cremation.
Well, how long after death, then, does the body become reactivated?
It's only a matter of minutes.
Minutes? Well, that doesn't give people time to make any arrangements.
No, you're right. It doesn't give them time to make funeral arrangements. The bodies must be carried to the street and burned. They must be burned immediately. Soak them with gasoline and burn them. The bereaved will have to forego the dubious comforts that a funeral service will give. They're just dead flesh and dangerous.
I see.
Judy, I need you to find some beds, friends, or sheets to tear up into small strips, okay? Is there a fruit cellar here?
Yes.
We need some bottles or jars. Make Molotov cocktails and hold them up while we try to escape.
Hey, there's a big can of kerosene down there.
I'll see what I can find.
I'll look for the bottles. There's a big key ring down there. There may be a key to the gas pump on it.
I'll check. We can toss the cocktails from a window upstairs. In the meantime, a couple of us can go out and try to get the gas. We can come back for the rest of the people.
But that'll leave a door open someplace.
Yeah, that's right. It better be this door. It's closer to the truck. Before we go out, we'll put some supplies behind the cellar door. While we're gone, the rest of you can hold up in there.
I found some fruit jars in the cellar. And there's a key on here that's labeled for the gas pump out back.
I'm not really that used to the truck. I found it abandoned.
I can handle the truck, no sweat.
You're it then. You and I'll go. We'll put whatever lumber we find behind the cellar door. You can go upstairs and toss the cocktails from a window. Tom, you and I will have to unboard this door. After you toss the cocktails, you hustle back down here and lock this door. It's no good to board it up because we'll have to get back in quickly. After we get the gas and get back into the house, then we'll worry about getting everybody into the truck. Now let's move it.
Hey man, the movie's only getting better, the tension is building, and we're getting closer to the first ever live horror film. But first man, back to our master thespian, Robert Richard George, with something a mighty bit scary.
Fearnet! Fearnet! The premier destination for horror! Is now available wherever and wherever you want. Yes, that's right. Free, full-length movies, horror movies, on full dimension, full-length, on-demand, online. And you can even take your worst fears on the go with your mobile device. Check out hearnet.com for more information. Woo! Now that's scary!
Watch those zombies eat their hearts out.
Where's that big smile for me?
Or hers, while Mike and his wife Kate sing a heartfelt love ballad when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Friday, Force Attacks G4.
Yes, it's true.
Join Kevin and Olivia at the first public screening of the most anticipated film of the year. It's Attack of the Show, Borat. Catch exclusive interviews, fan reactions, and a few surprises. Then, go deep inside the genius behind Borat with an all-new icon, Sacha Baron Cohen. Catch Attack of the Show, Borat, starting at 7, followed by an all-new Icons, Friday, only on G4.
Wield their powers. Feel their fury. Fight for justice. When the world needs heroes, no one else is in their league. Justice League Heroes. Rated T.
All-new Mazda CX-7, the SUV you never saw coming. It all comes back to...
Love cars? Thinking about a career as an automotive technician? Here are five reasons to call Universal Technical Institute right now. 1. UTI works with the industry's top auto manufacturers. 2. You'll train hands-on with today's diagnostic equipment. 3. UTI will help you find a great job after you graduate. 4. You can graduate in just over a year. And 5. UTI has campuses across the country.
The need for new technicians across all manufacturers is huge.
As a company, we've dealt with UTI since inception. We've always dealt with them because there is a need for highly skilled and trained technicians.
Our members, you know, always look to UTI as a place they can go to hire folks coming in an entry-level position.
The skills you gain at UTI will give you a head start in this fast-growing field where trained technicians are in high demand. Now it's time to make your move. Call right now to receive your information kit. Start training for your new career today. Universal Technical Institute.
The Mark and Mike Halloween Party continues right now.
Okay. Are we ready? Hey man, we are back and this is great. We have three dedicated volunteers, man, to try out for the lead in the zombie. Listen man, we ain't got a lot of time, so we gotta do this. And only your best will do. Number one, man, let's see 8 seconds of your best zombie. I mean, the walk, the talk, not the talk, the growl, dude. You know what I mean, man. Let's have it. God bless America. Okay, dude, you're next, man. Only your best will do. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Thank you, number two, Mr. Three. Let's go. Insane, insane. All right. Hey, man, we got to get back to Mike and Kate, man, and they're going to sing a special song during the next act of the film, man. Don't forget about our live horror film, too, coming up next, man. This is great. Thank you, guys, man. Thank you so much. One, two, and three. Excellent. Thank you.
Indications are that before this emergency is over, we will need many, many more such rescue patients.
You always have a smile for me. How can you smile like that all the time? How many do you have done? Come on, honey, we gotta move.
Tom, are you sure about the phone?
The phone is dead out. All you get is a recorded message.
If I could only call the folks, they're going to be so worried about us.
Everything will be all right. As soon as we get to Willard, we'll call them. They might even be there.
I know. Tom, are you sure we're doing the right thing, Tom?
What, about getting out of here?
Yeah.
Well, the television said that's the right thing to do. We've got to get to a rescue station.
I don't know.
Come on, honey, you're starting to sound like Mr. Cooper now.
But why do you have to go out there?
Look, I know how to handle that truck. And I can handle the pump. Ben doesn't know anything about that stuff.
We're safe in here.
We are safe now, but there's going to be more and more of those things.
I know all that.
Kill them all. It's time to kill them with a smile. Kill them all. It's not enough until they're dead inside their mind. For me, so you can kill them with pleasure.
We've got to do something. Fast.
I just don't want you to go out there, that's all.
Hey, Smiley. Where's that big smile for me? Boy, you're sure no use at all, aren't you? We got work to do, honey. And you...
Downstairs.
We have to go downstairs now, Barbara.
She's right. You have to go downstairs now, just for a little while, until we get back. Then we can all leave.
Oh, I'd like to leave. Yes.
We just got lucky with it. And gradually, we were able to raise more money, because as we were able to show footage, and you know, people could see that it looked like a movie, they were willing to invest. So we wound up with $70,000 of invested funds. And in the end, when we finished the film, it cost about $114,000, including money that we owed to people that were forgiving debt, you know, laboratories and things like that. So that was the total cost of the film. And we finished it here at one of these labs in Pittsburgh.
Hey, man, welcome back, man. Mike, yeah. Kate, great
yeah,
stuff,
thanks.
Man.
Thanks, we appreciate it. And by the way, if you go to g4tv.com, it'll tell you how to connect your computer to americanmovie.com, where you can buy a copy of my CD, Songs I Know.
Absolutely, and go to g4tv.com, man, and vote on the zombies, either one, two, or three. They all did a fantastic job, but we need one of them for our first ever live horror movie. Thank you.
Yeah.
When we come back, Mr. Cooper gets the zombies all fired up. And we're literally minutes away from the world premiere of the first live horror film ever made. So don't you dare go anywhere.
Stay tuned next for a sneak peek of Tenacious D and the Pick of Destiny, starring Jack Black and Kyle Gass, in theaters November 22nd.
Prepare yourselves for the motion picture experience of the century. Two righteous dudes on an epic quest to become the greatest rock and roll band of all time. But first they must find
the Pick of Destiny!
This pick is our ticket to genius.
We're never gonna find this thing.
Follow me. We are the shadows.
From New Line Cinema comes the most important film.
Sasquatch!
In the history of films.
We are Tenacious D. The greatest band on earth.
Black and Kyle Gass.
What?
Tenacious D in the Pick of Destiny.
Give me a power slide, full throttle.
How'd that feel?
Really good. How did it look?
Amazing. Bad.
I'm so scared.
Fear has a new address. A place where bad things don't just happen at night. The best horror, the most deranged killers, all just waiting for you. To get there, go to fearnet.com. Come on. What are you afraid of?
Now, back to Mark and Mike, live in their front yard.
Hey, man, welcome back. Welcome back, man. We're having a great time.
Yeah.
I've got my director's hat on. I've got a megaphone. I think we're going to do some auditioning. But hey, man, we're having a great time and live film coming right up, man.
Yeah.
Well, it first went out and it played in neighborhood theaters, drive-in movies, and, you know, for 4 or 5 weeks. It actually returned some money, returned about somewhere between $500,000 and $600,000. And we thought, it's over, you know. But hey, we made a few bucks, and this is an easy business. So we were wrong on all counts.
Come on!
Keep track of how much money that movie made. I've seen, I think industry listed around 14 or 15 million bucks. Forget about it. And that movie has played somewhere every night since 1968.
Mike, yeah, but that's the beauty of life.
Yeah, that was some kind of zombie attack.
Absolutely, man. Listen, man, everyone is pumped. They're getting ready for the film, the first live horror film, man. Let's just keep going for it.
All right.
Do you have the guts to stay tuned as Mark and Mike reveal the official results of your online votes when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues?
Welcome to the source for all the things you care about.
I love this show every frickin' day.
Attack of the Show, weeknights at 7 only on G4.
For the first time ever, the world's largest army of superheroes is under your control. Don't blow it. Marvel Ultimate Alliance, rated T for teen.
Multiply your possibilities. Introducing Intel Core 2 Duo, the world's best processors.
My father was my first coach. He taught me, he put the ball in my hand. He taught me the game, you know, to love the game. I think I got the love from the game from my father. He taught me the toughness of the game by beating me up all the time on the court. My high school coach taught me the fundamentals of the game, how to be fundamentally sound. And my college coach, he took it all and put it together took a young Shaq kid that had some talent by making me tougher.
My children are trapped in an airport on Christmas Eve.
Other companies, mine is stuck in a snowstorm, stranded at the airport all alone.
We're getting us out of here. Who's with me?
We gotta try to make it on our own.
It's gonna hurt when I pee.
Other companies, mine is stuck in a snowstorm.
Could this night get any better?
I've been good all year, fat boy.
Oh, what?
Oops, security, and now we're in.
Unaccompanied Minors, rated PG. Breakout December 8th.
Let's kick the tires and light the fire.
Woo! They got a lock on me. I'm punching out.
Like a video game, but deadlier. Dogfights, the new series. On the History Channel. Check your local listings.
Every time.
He came from nothing and redefined the American dream.
I buried those cockroaches!
His enemies wanted him dead.
Say hello to my little friend!
But Tony Montana doesn't die that easy. Tony's back. Scarface, the world is yours. Rated M for Mature.
Every dog passes today.
I found something really, really big that's really, really small. It's the Massively Mini Media Player. You can drag and drop your favorite music, download tons of free videos from tigertube.com, or even download a video you created. And it has a built-in radio, so you can listen to and record music. Good things really do come in Massively Mini packages.
It's the Massively Mini Media Player.
Each sold separately. Ask your parents' permission before going online.
You can look for Hillary CD in stores now.
Grab some sausage and kick back with Mark and Mike, live from Wisconsin.
Welcome back, man. We have the results of the contest. Look at this. The Demented Doctor wins for Mike Shank's costume. Very good, man. Now, the weapon of choice will be the block of cheese. The title for the film will be The Brain Dead Cheesehead. And the winner of the zombie contest, come in, contestant number two. You did beautiful, you did wonderful, man. Very good, man. That's live. Yeah.
Thank you.
3 o'clock yet. There's supposed to be another broadcast at 3 o'clock.
10 minutes.
Oh, only 10 more minutes? We don't have very long to wait. We can leave. Or we'd better leave soon. It's 3:10.
You know anything about this area at all? I mean, is Willard the nearest town?
I don't know. We were just trying to get to a motel before dark.
You said those things turned your car over. You think we can get it back on its wheels and drive it? Where is it?
Seems like it was pretty far away. Seems like we ran.
Forget it. It's at least a mile.
Johnny has the keys.
You're gonna carry that child a mile through that army of things out there?
I can carry the kid. What's wrong with her? How'd she get hurt?
One of those things grabbed her.
Bit her on the arm.
What's wrong?
Who knows what kind of disease those things carry? Is she conscious?
Barely.
She can't walk. She's too weak.
Well, one of us could try to get to the car.
You're gonna turn it over by yourself?
You can't start the car. Johnny has the keys.
You have a car? Where? Where is it?
You won't be able to start it.
Yeah, I know. But where is it?
Good Lord.
Hey, man, the tension is mounting. Heck, no. You could cut it with a chainsaw. Thank you, Mike. Live film coming up, man. This is just crazy, man.
I guess I had to have one.
I know you, Mike. You are a good man. Hey, listen, man, and we need you to call in. Call us back, man, live, crazy. Mike, keep eating, man.
Yeah.
The zombie search party resumes while Mark and Mike's zombie yard party rages on when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Mortal Kombat Armageddon, rated M for mature. Mortal Kombat Unchained available on PlayStation Portable.
You're finally home. I put your mail on the kitchen table. You got a movie from that DVD place. What's that about? Do you like waiting for movies to come in the mail? You should go to Vongo.com. For less than $10 a month, you can download all the movies you want. You even get your first 14 days free. Tell you what, you go to Vongo.com, I'll be in your kitchen making popcorn.
Why just watch films and TV shows when you can make them? Get behind the camera and turn your obsession into a profession with the help of Collins College. Their media arts program can put you on the fast track in video production or audio recording. You can make your living as a production assistant, assistant producer, cameraman, or editor. Call Collins College today.
Call now for a complimentary brochure. Operators are standing by. Call toll-free 888-823-0999. That's 888-823-0999. Call now.
RoboSapien V2. Sensory awareness. Engage stimuli.
Tracking red. Tracking blue. Is this a test? Blue.
Testing personality. Activate attitude.
Hello. Hi there. How's it going? Hey, baby. Who's your daddy?
RoboSapien V2. Approved.
RoboSapien V2. A fusion of technology and personality. Batteries not included from Wowie.
Yeah.
Available now at these fine retailers.
Honey, there's an article here about your poor leg circulation.
Peripheral artery disease, yeah?
I didn't realize PAD is so serious.
PAD puts you at more than double the risk of heart attack or stroke. So if you're diagnosed,
it's important to make sure you're doing everything you can to reduce that risk. You see, poor circulation in the legs could mean poor circulation in the heart and brain as well. That's a risk for heart attack or stroke. So get the facts if you've been diagnosed with PAD or have pain or heaviness in the legs.
I think I need to learn more about this.
Call 1-800-433-0182 for this free information about PAD, diagnosis, and treatment options to reduce the risk of heart attack or stroke.
I'm calling that number.
PAD is news to most people. Get the story with this free information kit. Call 1-800-433-0182 or visit PADupdate.com.
We now return to Night of the Living Dead, live from Wisconsin.
Hey, man, welcome back. Listen, man, we're going to keep watching Night of the Living Dead, but we're also going to take some phone calls. So this is going to be great, man. Keep watching, live film coming up as well.
Monitored closely by scientists at all the radiation detection stations. At this hour, they report the level of the mysterious radiation continues to increase steadily. So long as this situation remains, government spokesmen warn that dead bodies will continue to be transformed into the flesh-eating ghouls. All persons who die during this crisis, from whatever cause, will come back to life to seek human victims unless their bodies are first disposed of by cremation. Our news cameras have just returned from covering such a search and destroy operation against the ghouls, this one conducted by Sheriff Conan McClellan in Butler County, Pennsylvania. So now let's go to that film report. All law enforcement agencies and the military have been organized to search out and destroy the marauding ghouls. The Survival Command Center at the Pentagon has disclosed that a ghoul can be killed by a shot in the head or a heavy blow to the skull. Officials are quoted as explaining that since the brain of a ghoul has been activated by the radiation, the plan is kill the brain and you kill the ghoul.
Anything from the supply wagon, Cass?
No, we're all right.
Okay.
Hey, Cass, put that thing all the way in the fire. We don't want it getting up again.
All right, I got you. Chief McClellan, how's everything going?
Oh, things aren't going too bad. Men are taking it pretty good. You want to get on the other side of the road over there?
Chief, do you think we'll be able to defeat these things?
Well, we killed 19 of them today right in this area. Those last three we caught trying to claw their way into an abandoned shed. They must have thought somebody was in there. There wasn't, though. We heard them making all kind of noise. We came over and beat them off, blasted them down.
Chief, as soon as you're finished, can I sing you here?
Yeah, okay.
Chief, if I were surrounded by 6 or 8 of these things, would I stand a chance with them?
Well, there's no problem. If you had a gun, shoot them in the head. That's a sure way to kill them. If you don't, get yourself a club or a torch. Beat them or burn them. They go up pretty easy.
Well, Chief McClellan, how long do you think it will take you until you get the situation under control?
Excellent. This is just very beautiful, Mike. Yeah. I love this scene where they had the commentary with the head of the posse and all of that stuff. Listen, we got a phone call, Mike.
Yeah, I was just going to say that.
Thank you for saying that.
You're reading my mind.
And where's this phone call, Mike?
I don't know.
Excellent. So we should keep running with this commentary. Is that correct? Excellent, man. Well, listen, man, I think this is one of the favorite scenes for... Lindsay. Hello?
Yeah, we hear you.
You do. Mike, you better carry the conversation.
I don't know. Hello, is this Lindsay?
Do you want me to ask the question?
Yeah, what's the question, Lindsay?
If zombies eat flesh, why don't they eat each other?
I don't know. If zombies eat flesh, why don't they eat each other, Mark?
Mike, they're dead.
They're dead. It's because they're dead, Lindsay. It's because they're dead, Lindsay, is the answer.
Can she live with that?
Can you live with that?
Oh, excellent. Thanks, okay. Lindsay. Thank you
Thanks,
very much.
Lindsay.
Thank you very much.
So, yeah.
No. 2 people are dead already on account of that guy. Take a look out that window.
Thank you.
stick around for a heaping helping of Dad, the other white meat, and Zombie Pinata when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Friday, Ford attacks G4.
Yes, it's true.
Join Kevin and Olivia at the first public screening of the most anticipated film of the year. It's Attack of the Show, Borat. Catch exclusive interviews, fan reactions, and a few surprises. Then, go deep inside the genius behind Borat with an all-new icon, Sacha Baron Cohen. Catch Attack of the Show, Borat, starting at 7, followed by an all-new Icons, Friday, only on G4.
JB was born to rock.
Gotta get it on in the party zone.
KG was meant to shine.
It's with the hat, dude.
When they came together.
Oh. I've had this birthmark since I was born.
It was destiny.
It's the name of our band, dude.
Jack Black, Kyle Gass.
You have a remote.
Tenacious D in the pick of destiny. This film is not yet rated. Starts Wednesday, November 22nd.
Go quiet.
Get the ultimate ringtones from the ultimate band. You know, only from Rhino Tones. Text DOORS to 74466 and download DOORS ringtones now. Download the DOORS right to your phone. Text DOORS to 74466.
Rhino Tones, your phone is a better. Standard text messaging rate supply. See your contract for details.
Every pack of Magic the Gathering comes with 15 cards. And millions of players. Find them at playmagic.com.
We now join our irregularly scheduled program, Night of the Living Dead, live from Wisconsin.
Man, this is crazy. Listen, in tribute to little Karen killing her ma, we're gonna do the same kind of thing. This is sick. This is crazy. But you guys look familiar, man.
Yeah.
We're gonna do the stabbing of the pinata here, man. And I believe, are we ready for this insane event? Guys, give it your best, man. I don't know if I endorse it. This is sick. This is crazy. But go for it. Start stabbing it, man. Pass that trawl around, man. Woo! Somebody get in there. Yeah. Let me see that thing, man. This is crazy. Oh, my God. Back again. Live.
Sorry about that, guys.
Thank you.
I never expected this. But stay with us, please, man.
Party, while Mike and the zombies perform music to moan by.
On November 17, G4 takes you inside one of the most anticipated launches in gaming history. PS3 Day 1, November 17th, only on G4.
Brought to you by Acura. Acura. Advance.
The world is advancing, faster and faster. Are you in or out? Introducing the all-new 7-passenger Acura MDX. Technology takes it to a whole new place. Acura. Advance.
For the first time ever, the world's largest army of superheroes is under your control. Don't blow it. Marvel Ultimate Alliance, rated T for teen.
You move, man.
Multiply your possibilities. Introducing Intel Core 2 Duo, the world's best processors.
You know, you're moving, but you're moving in slow motion. You know, it's kind of like, you know, when you know, what you see in a movie, really. You know, it's everything in slow motion. Then when you pull up for that shot, when the ball is going in the air and it's like it's rotating real slow in a movie, that's how it is when you're watching it. Then the game is rotating very, very slow. And like I said, you're waiting just like everybody else waiting on seeing what the final result going to be. But when that ball goes through that net, whoo, it ain't too many better feelings than hitting the team, you know, with a game-winning shot.
Wield their powers. Feel their fury. Fight for justice. When the world needs heroes, no one else is in their league. Justice League Heroes. Rated team.
Just when you thought it was safe to turn on your TV, it's Mark and Mike. Welcome back.
Hey, man. Welcome back. The film's almost over.
Zombies or they will kill you. Zombie attack.
Zombies in an earthquake graveyard. Zombie affair. The flesh-eating zombies will take away your soul. Fear of the zombies. The victim flesh will empty your blood. Fear of the zombies. The bites of the zombies will burn you in hell. Run like hell, or find someone to protect you. Run like hell, if no one will help you, I'll take you to your grave.
Get about 4 or 5 men and a couple dogs. There's a house over here behind those trees. We want to go check it out.
Frank, you go here, Bill.
Yeah, Chief, we're going to stay with it till we meet up with the National Guard.
Where'd you get the coffee?
One of the volunteers. You're doing all the work. You take it.
Thank you. We should be wrapped up here about 3 or 4 more hours. We'll probably get into Willard's End. I guess you can go over there and meet the National Guard. Nick, you and the rest of these men want to come with me?
Well, Bill, I'm going to check in the office, see what's happening.
All right, Steve. Tell them we're going to stay with it, and everything appears to be under control.
Coming up next, the moment you've all been dying to see.
Good Lord.
The Halloween event of a lifetime. The first ever live horror film.
Tomorrow on Attack of the Show, the man and legend William Shatner will join us live in studio. Plus, we'll take you inside Mexico's electronic game show, and we found the hottest girls to become our MySpace Girl of the Week. It's Attack of the Show tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Mortal Kombat!
Every warrior has been summoned for one final battle. Mortal Kombat Armageddon. Rated M for mature. Mortal Kombat Unchained available on PlayStation Portable.
Between my two phone bills, it's probably about $60 a month.
About $150.
Probably $100 a month.
With Vonage, you get unlimited calls to anywhere in the U.S. and Canada, and all the cool features you could ever want are included. And it's just $24.99 a month.
Call 1-800-939-4VON.
Plus, get 1 month free.
Vonage, leading the Internet phone revolution.
Floyd Mayweather Jr., undefeated and the world's best pound-for-pound fighter.
Combinations by Mayweather.
Carlos Baldemir, welterweight champ and undefeated in his last 19 fights.
Hard right hand by Baldemir.
See what happens when these two warriors collide.
You'll never see better drama.
Pretty Boy takes the biggest risk of his career against its toughest opponent ever for the World Welterweight Championship. Mayweather versus Baldemir, Saturday, November 4th, live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View. Don't miss it live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View, Channel 123.
You are all set up now, sir. What do you think?
Fox Soccer Channel. Your world, your life, your game. Catch all the great soccer matches from FSC on Channel 613 or get the DirecTV Sports Pack by calling 1-800-531-5000. Professional and collegiate sports subscriptions sold separately. Blackout rules apply.
And now, back to the boys who put the sin in Wisconsin, Mark and Mike.
Hey, man, the grand finale of Night of Living Dead, and coming up next, the first ever live Halloween horror film. Do not go anywhere.
Night of the Living Dead, despite the fact that we got sort of knocked off and beat up by it, it's been fabulous. I mean, most of us are still working in the industry, and I've had a fabulous career based, you know, just mainly because of that film and the success of that film. So there's nothing to really, you know, moan about.
They need you down there by the barn. Down. I only need a few men to check out the house.
Somebody had a cookout here, Vince.
Yeah, sure looks like it, cop.
Get up here! Nick, Tony, Steve, you want to get out in that field and build me a bonfire? You, drag that out of here and throw it on the fire.
There's nothing down here?
All right, go ahead down and give him a hand. Let's go check out the house.
There's something there. I heard a noise.
All right, Vince, hit him in the head, right between the eyes. Good shot. Okay, he's dead. Let's go get him. That's another one for the fire.
Directly ahead. Over.
My God! You gotta hurry up! This is your very life! Those zombies are gonna get you!
Oh, man!
Oh, man, they're gonna get my wife, Kate, Mark. What are we gonna do? Oh, God, Mark. Kate's lost. She's fallen behind.
Mike, when you're right, man, those grilled sausages, they sure raise the undead, man!
Well, you know what, Mark? A male silkworm can, smell a female.
Oh, you're just amazing,
away.
Your encyclopedic knowledge!
Yeah, well, we...
Hey, man, we're being attacked by the undead! We need to take water and coffee!
How many do you think there are?
Well, 52.
Oh, my God, what are we going to do?
Yeah,
where
I don't know.
No.
I don't know.
Hey, man, that's the basement. That's the basement. Play it out. You got anything to win?
Yeah.
Send these guys up.
I don't know.
Thank you.
Kill
Thank you.
Zombies.
Hey, what's that?
My pizza.
Hey, man. Can you help us?
I can't help you now. No one can help you now. Only God can help you now.
Hey, good idea. Can you bless this tree?
Oh, now let me see if I'm fire and water.
What the hell happened?
I ordered a pizza that's not here.
Oh, Mike, we gotta get out of here,
okay,
man.
Let's go. Come on.
Come on, we gotta break through! Ah!
Help!
Mike! Mike!
Yeah, I know, it's bad.
I am not a crook! Let's go, Mike!
It's bad, it's really bad. But we've gotta get out of here. Well,
Mike!
No, Mark. All we really wanted to do it in the first place to make the world a better place to live in.
No! Hell no! Live for today! Live for tomorrow! Keep fighting! Keep God on the roll! Only in America!
The zombie search party resumes while Mark and Mike's zombie yard party rages on when G4's Night of the Living Dead screening continues.
Coming up next on G4, X-Play, the scariest games of all time. Then, Arrested Development, Ninja Warriors all new on Midnight Spank, followed by Brainiac.
Craziest head I know is gonna be a fed.
On November 10th.
The one boy!
Harsh times call for harsh measures.
I'm a soldier of the apocalypse.
Oh, you gonna be happy once he's dead?
Harsh times.
Rated R. In theaters, November 10th.
The Pontiac G6 series offers more combinations of options and accessories than there are drivers in America. G6 sedan, coupe, or hardtop convertible. Choose a shape, then build yours at Pontiac.com. Now, introducing the GM 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, plus courtesy transportation and roadside assistance on every 2007 vehicle we make.
Here at the Chic Shave Lab, we have been testing the new Chic Quattro Titanium in simulated social environments to see if it really is off the heating.
3, 2, 1.
Off the heezy, indeed.
New Chic Quattro Titanium stays sharp to give you a close, smooth shave with less irritation than the leading brand. It's the only razor with 4 advanced blades made with titanium.
New Chic Quattro Titanium, the power of 4 meets titanium.
Gary! What are you doing?
Shining up my ATV.
Why?
Because it's dirty.
From now on, your name will be Sally.
Hi, Sally. Hi.
More vehicles, more tracks. ATV Off-Road Fury 4. Rated E for everyone. The Dirt Gods are pleased.
Unleash the power of Robo-Reptile. Robo-Reptile claims his territory, stalking his prey with biomorphic bursts of speed. Part reptile, part technology, all attitude. Robo-Reptile, a fusion of technology and personality. Batteries not included. From Wowee.
Welcome to the jungle. We got fun and games. We got everything you want. We know the name. We are the people that can find whatever you may need. If you got the money, honey, we got your disease. Jungle, welcome to the jungle. It's gonna bring you down.
Grand
Theft Auto San Andreas. Out now on PlayStation 2. Rated M for mature.
Welcome back to Halloween, Wisconsin style. Here's Mark and Mike.
Hey man, thank you, everybody for this first time ever live event. First time, man. Man, and have a very, very, very good night. Thank you, G4 TV. Thanks to everybody. It's just to mention names would be crazy, wouldn't it, Mike?
Yeah, sure would.
So we want to thank everybody, man, definitely. Night of Living Dead, G4, everybody.
I guess my favorite moment was when you attacked those zombies with this block of cheese that we voted as a weapon of choice here on Halloween night on G4.
What kind of cheese is that?
That's Colby cheese.
Woo!
Absolutely. Hey, what was your favorite moment, man? Talk to us.
Definitely the smoke.
Colby on the smoke.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a mini Mike and a mini Mark, man.
It's okay. It's all right. There's something to live for.
Yeah. Absolutely. Thank you. Good night. God bless you all and happy Halloween.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Morgan, is that you?
Adam, is that you?
I think so. Hold on.
Where are we? What's going on? Oh, God. Oh, my God.